Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let me show you how to set a custom alert sound on your Mac. So the system alert sound is something that sounds when you're trying to do something and the system needs to alert you, like a dialog box pops up asking you for permission, or perhaps you're trying to delete a file that can't be deleted. And it wants to play a sound to alert you to that. And if you go to System Preferences, Sound, Sound Effects, like I just did, you can see the different built-in system alert sounds. And you can select one. And whichever one you have selected, that will be the one that's your system alert sound. You can also select to have the alert sound play through a different set of speakers, like for instance the internal speakers as opposed to line out where your music might go to, and set a volume for the alert sound as well. Now, it can be fun to actually have your own custom alert sound to make your Mac different from everybody else's Mac. So there is a built-in way to allow you to do this. Unfortunately, you can't just drag and drop, but this is a supported way, not kind of a hack. If you go into the Finder and you use the Go menu, and I'm going to hold down the Option key till the library appears. And I'm going to go basically to my library folder, which is there alongside my documents and movies and music and pictures folder. It's just that it's hidden. That's why I have to use Go with the Option key to get to it. And here in my library folder, and this is my user library folder, not the system one, I have a folder called Sounds. And it's probably empty on your Mac because this is where custom sounds go. So I'm going to add some custom sounds here and get them to appear in the sound system preference, so that I can use them as alert sounds. So I've got a folder here on my desktop called My Sounds, and I've got two sounds in it. And there are two different file formats. One is the AIFF file format, and the other is an MP3. And I'm going to drag these both into the Sounds folder. I'm going to hold down the Option key to make a copy of them, and now they're both in there. And neither one is going to right away appear in Sound Effects here. I find that the best way to get them to appear is to quit System Preferences, reopen System Preferences, and then go back to Sound and Sound Effects. And we should see one of these here. And we've got Chimes and Knocks. So we look and sure enough there's Chimes. And it even says type is custom as opposed to built in. But we'll notice Knock is not there. So the reason Knock is not there is it's not the right file format. Or is it? Because I find that actually you can use a variety of file formats like an MP3. But you simply change the file name to be AIFF, drag that into the Sounds folder. Let's get rid of that MP3 version there. And then when we restart System Preferences, go to Sound, Sound Effects, we'll find that Knock is there and it works as well. So I think if you really want to be safe and do everything the right proper way, it's probably best to actually convert that from MP3 or WAV or whatever it is into a real AIFF file. You can use an app like Audacity to do that. I also found that you can use QuickTime Player and export as audio, and when you do that it's an M4A file. Change file name to AIFF and that works, and at least you know you're using a more modern file format than MP3. But if it works, then I guess it works and you can use it. And it's a quick, easy way to add custom sounds here and then be able to go in and change it anytime you want, or just have a really neat custom built-in sound. One good reason for doing this is a lot of times people find these sounds kind of annoying. You hear them over and over and over again. So having something that's a non-annoying sound is kind of a nice thing to have on your Mac to make it a little more pleasant to use.